They're known as the 3000ers, an elite, some might say slightly mad group, who've climbed every peak in Aotearoa above 3,000 metres. What does it take to join their ranks? Resilience, strength, determination, sure. But for Gavin Lang, who also took stunning photographs of all 24 of those peaks, a fear of heights might have been his secret weapon.
I think anybody who wants to overcome fear of heights needs to also have the seed of adventure.
Yeah, boy.
I've had to overcome a fear of heights to be able to go mountaineering successfully and not be riddled with anxiety just dealing with standing on the top of a mountain.
Ah, beautiful.
I can understand why people think I'm a bit mad to go and face that fear of heights. I'm certain that there's no room for growth if I don't face those fears.
Here you go. Beautiful.
That's messed up.
It's pretty unlikely that a person from a fairly low-level country like Ireland ends up in New Zealand as a mountaineering guide, but I followed my heart. I'm Gavin Lang, and I've been mountaineering in New Zealand since 2002. I currently live in Wanaka. The mountains to me feel like a place I can go and reflect. They are nature in all its glory. The mountains are like a church for me. Every mountain is different, and every trip is different. Every sunrise and sunset's different.
It's an angle I've never seen before. It's quite beautiful.
I was very curious as a child. My dad's camera was this box of tricks that just looked really fascinating. You know, I tried cityscapes and I tried baby photography and a little bit of real estate photography, but the thing that really floated my boat was shooting people moving through the mountain landscapes. That really interested me. I knew when I saw those two climbers walking away from Pioneer Hut, that mist and the mood of that whole shot would look perfect as a black and white. I reckon I'm surely deserving of a diploma or something similar from the University of YouTube. Most of my learning has come from watching tutorials of other photographers. The Silberhorn Ridge and just some nice soft light, the very, very first slivers of light, early morning. I think it's 4 a.m. It's a very time-consuming task, especially if your goal is to always have good weather on the summit. Half an hour before this photograph was taken, the whole area was covered in cloud, and an hour before, it was snowing. But as always with the weather, it's a case of trusting that the forecast will come right. This is Alistair McDowell leading out towards the summit of Mount Tykelman, and you can tell from the rope how it's being pulled out to the left, how strong the wind was.
Sure did. Nice work.
Got this idea to video the most interesting peaks in New Zealand. Here we are on the summit ridge of Mount Cook, the High Mile. It's the first time I've ever climbed to a list, you know? It wasn't something I set out specifically to do. I want to climb 24 3,000 meter peaks. It was incidental.
We're up at Middle Peak Hotel. Sun's going down, it's getting a bit cooler, but the views are spectacular.
It's hard work. And you need a lot of patience, you need a lot of time. It's a great goal, but it's not something you'll finish in a weekend.
Oh, that's a beautiful shot there.
Hi, I'm Jen. I'm Gavin's wife.
And sometimes I feel like I'm a mountaineer's widow.
What would you say was the most irritating part?
The hardest part is that your work and your passion is dictated by the weather. So every time the weather's good, you're up and you're gone within a matter of days. And any routine that we have in place is out the window.
There's only two types of weather, whether to go or whether to stay. The most common question you get asked is about whether you're worried or anxious about me not coming back, dying in the mountains.
It's a pretty quick, no, I don't worry, because I feel like worrying is a waste of my energy. And my gosh, the number of days that you've spent out in the mountains and the days that I haven't heard from you, that would be a lot of worry on my back. I know that death is a risk and we've spoken about it. And I also know that you mitigate risk very well, that you have turned away from things that seem like they are too high risk. It's all about the journey for you rather than getting to the top.
I'm not in complete control, but I'm trying to control risk as much as possible. That's all I can do. And I rely on my own judgment and my own balance, and my own skills to stay on the mountain and make calls about when I should go a particular way or not. Will I carry on or will I go home?
So we're breaking up camp this morning after deciding not to carry on over the Trans-Tasman Traverse.
Most significant injury I had from mountaineering wasn't from an accident or a fall, but from overuse, overwork. I found something that I loved doing and I overdid it. I had three herniated discs in my neck, which created massive pain down my arm and neurological damage, put me out of guiding for over a year. I didn't know if I'd be able to climb again. It was the biggest wake-up call I ever had. Overcoming that injury was very hard. It was a massive exercise in patience. Meditation played a huge role. You know, we can heal a lot with our minds. Hardest thing I ever did. Harder than climbing any mountain, because just being alone and quiet with your own thoughts is extremely hard. I found the benefits of cold water immersion to be quite profound. 7:15, let's go, boom, in the lake. When I get into the water and I feel that cold, there's initially a feeling of pain, and that subsides after about 20, 30 seconds tops. And then it just feels like a warming sensation, funnily enough.
Scary.
No, you'll be fine.
Sure?
Yeah. People ask me, so what now, or what's the most important thing for you moving forward?
Yes!
My daughter, she's now 7, nearly 8. I've done as many trips in the mountains with her as possible.
Perfect.
I mean, I can see it in her eyes. I can see how mind-expanding it is for her.
What's this one?
It's equipping her with the knowledge that she can overcome difficulties and overcome things she didn't know were possible. There are now 13 people who've climbed all 24 3,000 meter peaks. I was the 11th. I just get so amped thinking about the potential shot that I might get. We're mostly trying to avoid moving around in the dark, but the moments leading out of the darkness or into the darkness are definitely the most interesting.
So stunning. Well, Gavin's already planning his next major conquest. Next year, he's aiming to knock off the world's fifth highest mountain, McCallum in Nepal. Gavin's new book, Seeking the Light, is in bookstores from September 14. Head to our Facebook page for more details.